All right, good morning everybody, and welcome to another weekend adventure here out on the Olympic Peninsula. As you have probably already recognized, behind me there is David with Off the Grind. Many of you have probably recognized his truck and himself because we had done the trail cleanup together out in Greenwater, Washington, not too long ago. So we decided to head out on another trip here. We're just going to simply explore around the area and just enjoy the cooler temps here on the peninsula, because unfortunately Washington is yet again going into triple digit heat more on the inland, so it's nice to kind of escape that and get to some cooler weather. So the weekend should bring some awesome trips and places to explore, so looking forward to where we're going to be heading. Our itinerary for the weekend was simple. Explore as many random forest roads as we could, with hopes to find a decent camp at the end of the day. Besides the major attractions along the far west side of the peninsula, we pointed the trucks north to see what sparked the curiosity along Highway 101. The first stop of the day brought us to a rather visually stunning boat launch along the Queets River. The water was slow moving and calm. I sometimes kick myself on trips like this for not bringing the fishing pole, though maybe that will change in the near future. Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Yeah, 100%.
I'll lead the way. And that was a fat bust. Never mind, just dead-ended.
Just goes to show that not all trails lead to an incredible find. Our luck of prospecting future campsites along this main road ended earlier than expected due to active construction work forcing closures. With this now in mind, we pulled up Gaia GPS and rerouted ourselves for finding a place to enjoy lunch.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Well, all right, everybody. After a long day of just checking out adjacent trails from our campsite and kind of venturing north on the 101, we came across quite a few interesting things. A lot of gated trails, unfortunately, roads that were closed due to construction, a lot of people out during the summer months as they should be, so many of the forecasted sites were taken. So we ended up backtracking and came to a spot, a new area that either of us had explored before, which is kind of right along a creek here, which is pretty nice. Being that it is wide open like this, we do have a couple neighbors, but it's not too bad for kind of what we're getting for a backup to our backup. But overall, it was a nice day of exploring. If anything, it was nice to get out and just kind of revisit some fun areas on the far west side of the peninsula. But since we have camp all set up now, we're just gonna kind of hang out, unwind from being in the trucks all day, and work on some dinner later this evening. So looking forward to that and just relaxing.
So tonight we're having chicken pesto gnocchi. I made the pesto at home, so it's just basil, some chicken stock, and Parmesan cheese, all blended up with some milk in it, and then pan sear the gnocchi, throw some chicken in there, and good to go.
Thank you. Look at that, everybody. Another meal not needing to be cooked by me.
With breakfast and coffee completed, it was a slow start to the day getting back out on the trails. The countless miles behind the wheel and numerous unforeseen closures within the area had us wanting to find camp early in the day and simply relax. So we packed up camp and headed east towards Wainuchi Lake to see what we could find. When it comes to getting outdoors, being with the right company can sometimes make all the difference. David, thank you so much for tagging along with me on this trip. I'm definitely looking forward to the next adventure. Though until next time, safe travels.